chosen, we are Christ's of one another. We are promised to tomorrow while we are for him today. We are sign, we are wonder, we are sower, we are seed. We are harvest, we are hunger, we are question, we are greed. Then when can we stand justified in what we can believe? In no one else but he who suffered nothing more than he who rose, who was justice for the poor, who was rage against the night, who was hope for peaceful people, who was light. We are called, we are chosen, we are Christ for one another. We are promised to tomorrow, and we are for him today. We are sign, we are wonder, we are sower, we are seed, we are harvest, we are hunger, we are question,
we are greed.
We are greed.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, all right, very well. Well, we have been working in the sound system. As you can see, we have new speakers. So on the walls, hopefully, and Thursday, they will come to a charge to the whole system. So we're hoping to have a good sound system here in the church. Let us begin to celebrate this Mass Sunday, the day of the Lord. You know, we are in the kingdom of heaven. Every time we come to Mass, we are in the kingdom of heaven, because the kingdom of heaven is where Jesus is. And Jesus is truly present, especially here in the Eucharist, in many ways, in many parts, but especially in the Eucharist. Let us prepare our hearts, our minds, and to receive what Jesus has to give us today. He wants to bless us, as we hear that in the Gospel. As we prepare to celebrate this Mass, we empty ourselves from all these things that we had put into our hearts. We call sin. We recognize with humility, with sincerity, that we have sinned, and we ask God for forgiveness and strength.
I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words and what I have done. And what I had failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. O God, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises, which surpasses every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, observe what is right, do what is just. For my salvation is about to come, my justice about to be revealed. The foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, ministering to him, loving the name of the Lord, and becoming his servants. All who keep the Sabbath free from profanation and hold to my covenant, them I will bring to my holy mountain and make joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and sacrifices will be acceptable on my altar. For my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I am speaking to you, Gentiles. Inasmuch as I am the apostle to the Gentiles, I glory in my ministry in order to make my race jealous and thus save some of them. For if their rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance be but life from the dead? For the gifts and the call of God are irrevocable, just as you once disobeyed God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience. So they have now disobeyed in order that by virtue of the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God delivered all to disobedience that he might have mercy upon all. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
With
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a Canaanite woman of that district came and called out, "Have pity on me, Lord, son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But Jesus did not say a word in answer to her. Jesus' disciples came and asked him, "Send her away, for she keeps calling out after us." He said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and did Jesus homage, saying, "Lord, help me." He said in reply, "It is not right to take food of the children and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their masters." Then Jesus said to her in reply, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And the woman's daughter was healed from that hour. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
About 2 years ago, the husband of my sister, my youngest sister, became very ill. He became very ill and cancer and And well, we as a family make a group to pray for him for healing, and we pray. I mean, really hurt, and I believe in that. At that time, my prayer was very sincere to God, Lord. I mean, my younger sister is very young. Well, he was 42 by then, and I mean, she's losing her husband and very difficult situation. Please grant him the help he needs to continue supporting his family. And what we were praying. Well, my sister's husband died, and I was very disappointed. I can tell you, I was very disappointed because my prayer was a lot of faith. I felt it. Well, he died, and I told the Lord, why you did not allow this? Why you didn't grant us what we asked you to do? It. We believe it's a good thing, you know. And we were very disappointed. So I went to Mexico to see my sister. Oh my God, she really gave me strength. If it is the will of God, she told me, I accept it. Oh, she was stronger than me. Her faith was much, much stronger than mine. I could see that. She accepted that. I mean, she was losing her husband. And oh my God, powerful faith. You know, powerful faith. No wonder that it's a gift from God. In today's readings, we have another woman. Came to Jesus. You know, this is kind of gospels. We don't want to see it, you know. Why did Matthew include this story in his gospel? It is a historical aspect. It's not a parable Jesus is telling. That happened. And Matthew included for a reason. So this woman comes. She was not a Jew. She was a Gentile. She came. She was a Canaanite, which means the Canaanites there were living in the promised land. So when Israel came into the promised land, they had to fight against them and get rid of them in order to possess the promised land. So there were enemies. And well, that woman comes to Jesus. Imagine all this. That woman comes to Jesus by herself. Very rare in that time that a woman may walk from afar, coming by herself to see somebody. A woman has to bring her husband with her. Probably she didn't have any husband. Okay, she comes to him and begging something very important for her. My daughter is possessed by a demon. She's tormented by a demon, Lord. I mean, why that woman come to Jesus for this thing to happen? Most likely, she had heard about Jesus. Most likely, she heard that Jesus was expelling demons and that Jesus did not reject anybody. So that courage, or that gave her courage to come to Jesus by herself and ask for this miracle to happen. And she comes and kneels in the presence of Jesus and then asks, Lord, help me. Help my daughter. Help, by helping my daughter, you are helping me, Lord. You are doing a great thing for me. And what is the attitude of Jesus? You know, very indifferent. I mean, we can imagine this passage, Jesus not even turn to her and say, oh, you know, not even pay attention to her. So she must be insisting until the disciples said, they come to say, Lord, I mean, grant what she desires, because look at her. She's bothering us, and send her away. And Jesus keeps this, because remember, Jesus always takes any opportunity to teach his disciples. The disciples are the ones who are continuing Jesus' mission. So they have to be very clear what it is all about. So Jesus takes this opportunity to teach the disciples. I am sent for the children of Israel. By saying this, we go back to the first reading. Brook of prophet Isaiah. And even from the very beginning of the Bible, you know, when God promised Abraham, you will be a blessing for all the nations. Not only for a certain people, for all the nations. And in the book of prophet Isaiah, in today's reading, it says, all nations will come to the temple of the Lord, because the house of the Lord is a house of prayer. A house where everybody is welcomed. Everybody for any nations. I can imagine the people of the time of the prophet Isaiah were thinking what he was saying this, because the people of Israel said, we are the chosen one, and everybody else is a dog, like a dog. You know, that's what we heard today in today's gospel, right? So we are the chosen one. Other people, you know, they are Gentiles, they are pagans. They're not part of the people of God as we are. So I can imagine the people who read Isaiah, who heard Isaiah, when he said the house of the Lord is a house of prayer for all the nations, for all peoples to come. And everyone who worships God, anyone who strives to obey God's commandments are very much welcome and will enjoy what you are enjoying right now. So this woman comes to Jesus and asks. Jesus is teaching his disciples, remember what happened that time. Remember what the prophet said about it. Never forget that. Never forget that. So the lady insisted, and Jesus finally turns to her and said, it is not right to give the food of the children and give it to the dogs. Usually the word dogs is not like dogs. It's like a little dog, like a puppy. You know, but instead, I'm making a great difference. You know, what is the attitude of this woman? You know, wonderful, wonderful attitude. According to the scholars, the attitude of the woman is the attitude of all nations. Must be the attitude of all nations. This woman is recognizing Jesus as the Messiah, because she recognized Jesus as the Lord. It's like she's saying, you are the Messiah of Israel. You are the Savior. You come to bring us salvation. You come to this. And even these little scraps coming from the table, even the leftovers of the people of Israel, has the power to heal the whole nations, has the power to give us salvation. It's when she said, even the scraps that came or that comes from the table, or the children, the dogs eat. It's a wonderful faith. Let us turn a little bit last Sunday gospel. You remember last Sunday gospel, right? Because you have a very good memory. You know, you have a good memory. Well, Jesus is walking on the sea. You remember that? The disciples are in the boat and they are struggling with the wind and big waves. Jesus comes to them. And they were terrified because they thought he was a ghost. And Jesus says, have courage, it is I. And Peter, what Peter says, you remember, if it is you, Lord, call me to be with you. Help me to walk on the sea as well as you are doing this. And Jesus says, come, Peter, come. And Peter began to walk on the seas until he realized how strong, how dangerous was the sea. And he began to sink. And then says, Lord, save me. Lord, save me. I'm sinking. I'm dying. I'm terrified. Immediately, Jesus extends his hands, takes Peter's hand, and put him into the boat. And then Jesus says, oh, men of little faith. Look at this. All men of little faith. Today's gospel, woman, how great is your faith? You know, the person of Jesus, the very person of Jesus, has the power to give us what this woman has. She represents us, because we are Gentiles, we are not Jews, or probably one of you are the descendant from a Jew, but most of us are Gentiles. And this woman represents us. This is the kind of faith we are called to have. As we recognize Jesus, as we travel in our everyday life, as we struggle begging Jesus one and one more time, and sometimes we feel that rejection of Jesus, or Jesus not paying attention to our prayer, to our situations, you know, this woman says, continue. Continue praying. Never lose courage. That woman represents us to strive, to strive. And eventually, the woman receives what she needed in her life because of her faith. You know, faith, the faith of the people of God is the tenderness of the heart of Jesus. You know, Jesus is able to change his mind for the faith of a people, for the one who shows true intention. You may remember the Blessed Virgin Mary in the wedding of Cana, right? When there were no wine. And Mary comes to Jesus and says, look, they have no wine. Well, Mother, it's not my time yet, you know? And then Mary, who knows very well the heart of Jesus, said to the servant, do whatever he tells you. And Jesus gave to them not only more wine, the best wine, the best wine. You know, faith, how important is faith? You know, sometimes we are moved by reason. We are taught in schools and universities and colleges to use our reason, and that is very good. You know, Pope John Paul II wrote an encyclical, says faith and reason, how reason is so important for our faith. But reason has to reach just a certain point, and then faith comes after. Reason embraces the faith, and believed. You know, we can have what this woman has. Courage, perseverance, until the end. By Jesus granting her what she desired, it is like a Jesus granting the whole world salvation. How great is your faith? Well, faith is important, very important, essential in our lives. We can question God, but we can embrace at the end, like this woman, we can embrace in our minds, in our reason, we can embrace the faith that Jesus taught us. If God speaks, God wants to give the gift. So today Jesus speaks about faith. Let us receive this gift and let us embrace it. Lord, that sometimes I don't understand, but I believe, I embrace, and I praise you. Amen. And now, as a church, let us profess our faith as we say, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, and for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We bring our prayers to our merciful God with joyous hearts.
For the church, that we may be instruments of God's mercy, guides for all who are seeking God, and companions to those developing a relationship with God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For an end to violence in families, neighborhoods, and cities, that God will open new ways to resolve differences and protect the life and dignity of each person and bring an end to war, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have helped to strengthen our faith, for parents, teachers, and those who give witness by the fidelity of their life, that they may continue to be examples of Christian discipleship to all who encounter them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For refugees and immigrants, particularly those fleeing violence, that God will ease their suffering, guide them to safety, and stir the hearts of many to assist them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are recovering from hurricanes, wildfires, explosions, or other disasters, that God will ease their pain, give them strength, and renew their hope, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are sick, that God's healing love will strengthen them, remove their pain, and restore them to wholeness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For students as they start school, particularly those who will be away from home for the first time, that God will help them learn, stay safe, and find the resources that they need to assist them in the coming months, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our personal petitions, for those who have asked for our prayers, for those whose names are written in our prayer request book, and for those who have died recently, Peggy Merrick, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for the special intentions of this Mass, Linda Ramon and Evelyn McCormick, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Heavenly Father, hear our prayers and grant us what we need. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please join us in our offertory hymn, number 718 in the green books, Love One Another, number 718 in the green books.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for to your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord,
receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your every self, very self, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son, and by the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, may the body of Christ in the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, by the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the church. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy this gift we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, in need of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Luke, and with all the saints of whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gustavo, our Bishop, the other our bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and
forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Pray this act of spiritual communion for our brothers and sisters who are not able to join us. And we pray, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Please join us in our communion hymn, number 808 in the Green Books. Shepherd of Souls, number 808 in the Green Books.
Let us pray. Made partakers of Christ to these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Please have a seat for a moment.
As our ushers come forward, we thank you with your assistance passing out the baskets today. The second collection today is for the St. Vincent de Paul. Religious education and faith formation. Our religious education and faith formation staff are in the vestibule of the church after Mass throughout the month of August to take registration for all classes, kinder, high school, and RCIA. Please stop by and pick up or fill out a registration form. Classes begin on Sunday, after Labor Day. We know that it's really hot again today, and we don't want you slaving over a kitchen for brunch when you get home. So please go outside and enjoy some of the tacos that the Knights of Columbus are selling today. It'll save you from heating up your kitchen, and you can have a little fellowship outside as well. The Guadalupanas are hosting their annual bingo on Sunday, August the 20th. I believe that's today, from 3 to 6 p.m. in the parish hall. The doors are open at 1 p.m. today. The CYO registration is open throughout today, ending today, for ages 4 plus for soccer, flag football, volleyball, and cheer. Mark your calendars for their fourth annual golf tournament on October the 6th that supports our program. Field upgrades and families in need needing sports registration assistance. See the bulletins for more details on the CYO ministry. At this time, we'd like to offer our traveling chalice. And this week, chalice Mike and Yvonne Garcia, if you'll come forward, please. And as they're coming forward, we ask you to turn to the back of your hymnal and join with us. God, in baptism you called us by name, made us members of your people, the church. Guide us to know our vocation in life and to respond by living your spirit of holiness. For your greater glory and for the service of your people, raise up dedicated and generous members who will serve their lives as women and men, religious, priests, deacons, married or single. Send your spirit to so we may serve your people, following the example of your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name we offer this prayer. Amen. And thank you again for taking the challenge. So at this time, we'd like to recognize any first-timers or any visitors here to St. Luke today to please stand up and be recognized. Any visitors with us today? I see none. So how about birthdays and anniversaries this past week or the upcoming week? Please stand up. So we have some birthdays in the back. Birthdays, lots of birthdays it looks like today. Birthdays here, birthdays over here. Any anniversaries, just all birthdays? Okay, oh, God bless. Thank you, 50 years. So please join with us if we say a blessing for those celebrating their birthdays and anniversaries. God of all creation, we offer you grateful praise for the gift of life. Hear the prayers of your servants who recall today the gifts of their birth and their anniversary as they rejoice in your gifts of life, love, family, and friends. Bless them with your presence. Surround them with your love, that they may enjoy many happy years, all of them pleasing to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And congratulations. So please stand for the final blessing.
Just before the final blessing, our registrations for a confirmation shortly will begin. You know, our confirmation director retired, and we are in the process of hiring a new confirmation director. But Father Jorge is stepping out, and stepping in and helping in this process and help the confirmation program. Yeah. So probably next week we'll be receiving the registration for confirmation. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Mass has ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve our Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Be to God.
And please join us in our closing hymn, number 610 in the Green Books. Give thanks to the Lord, number 610 in the Green Books. Bless the Lord.